In honor of National Heart Health Month, we have taken Motion Capture Monday and brought it from the biomechanics lab into the exercise physiology lab. Today, we're going to be looking at various parts of fitness and heart health, as cardiovascular disease is the number one leading cause of death in the United States. Our focus here in regards to exercise physiology is to really help promote individuals to get up and become active. So today we're going to be looking at some tests that will show you a little bit deeper insight with that.
So the VO2 max test is basically the gold standard in understanding how fit they are as an endurance athlete.
The heart is the hardest working muscle in the body, beating over 100,000 times each day for the average individual. That's over 3 billion times in your lifetime.
EKG tracks the electrical activity of the heart as it contracts.
So with our different waveforms, we have our P wave right here, which is actually with the top of the heart depolarizing and essentially the top of the heart contracting. Our QRS complex is the bottom of the heart depolarizing or contracting. And then we have our T wave, which is this last waveform right here, which is actually that bottom of the heart or those ventricles relaxing.
You can also track your physical activity by Fitbits or other physical activity trackers. Many people hear that 10,000 steps per day is a pretty ambitious goal for trying to get individuals to be up and active. And while the evidence shows that there are many health benefits with 10,000 steps per day goal, that really we like to follow the lines of any physical activity is better than some and more is better than none.